Winchester repeating carbine and kept a sharp watch for any sign of trouble. Meanwhile, the low breed Kira and Toto guided their horses east along the canyon rim to meet the stagecoach. Suddenly, the masked man signaled a halt. He took binoculars from their case as Toto said,
"Why we stop here, Kimasabi? Trail at the bottom of canyon, 2 miles east of here."
"There are Indians in the canyon, Toto. About 200 yards to the east."
"Ah, we see them."
"I see two white men with them. They seem to be talking. Toto, this means trouble."
"Indians not friends?"
"So the renegade Toto is a black bear."
"Oh. Stage come this way, then sure stop it."
"You ride to meet the westbound stage as far from here as possible and warn the driver. I'll try to get help from Fort Miles."
"Soldiers at Fort Miles. Try long time to capture Black Bear."
"Well, this is their chance. Come to us!"
While the masked man dashed away from the canyon, Toto rode quietly along the rim until he was well past the Indians who were gathered below. Then Toto rode fast for 2 miles, where he descended to the canyon floor. He dashed along the rocky canyon until he saw the approaching stage. He drew rein and raised one hand.
On stagecoach.
Head on the ear. I'm right here, and I'm covering you with a fast repeating carbine. If you're planning a holdup.
No. Me here, give one. Bad Indian to head.
Is this some kind of a trick?
No, it's not a trick. Black Bear there. Him got plenty Indian with bow and arrow.
I hear Indians. He must be telling the truth. Jump in Sassafras. We can't turn around in this canyon.
Indians come this way.
There's just one thing to do. We have to get behind the biggest of these bowlers and make a stand.
Me fight with you. Maybe hold off Indians till help come.
Help? Where does help come from?
Lone Ranger, ride for soldiers.
Black Bear and his followers dashed through the canyon with Slade and Merkel. When they hear the halted stage, gunfire came from behind big boulders.
They were waiting for it.
Let's go.
It was a pitched battle in the canyon. Most of the Indians had bows and arrows, but several had old-fashioned rifles. Their gunfire blended with the pistol fire of Slade and Merkel. Toto, Jim Bledsoe, and the driver fought back from behind boulders.
No! They got me!
The driver dropped his weapon and slumped to the ground. Toto and Jim maintained their fire.
Can't hold out much longer. I'm nearly out of ammunition.
We just fired the last shot.
The last of mine is in my rifle. Now I'm out. We're through. We're at their mercy. What's that?
It's bugles. It means soldiers.
Again and again, the bugle sounded a message of hope and rescue. The Indians heard it, and so did Slade and Myrtle. But before they could decide whether to attack or retreat, a detachment of cavalry swept around the bend of the canyon, with a masked man in the lead. The soldiers opened fire from the saddle, and their fire was devastating. They swept past the stagecoach in full pursuit of the Indians who tried to escape. Dressed the stagecoach driver's wounds, while the Lone Ranger shook hands with Jim Bledsoe.
And here is the man.
The people of Booneville will be everlastingly grateful to you.
And to you, sir.
There's so very scouty paper.
I reckon the soldiers will be mighty grateful, too, after capturing those groups and Black Bear's renegades. There's a lot of folks grateful to the Lone Ranger.
Oh,